This is just a small project in InDesign which attempts to recreate the video poster from Haryy Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban. So there are a few things that we want to cover in this particular session. One is the use of layers, putting graphics on top of a video, putting frames with text into the page and then exporting that to the Publish Online and EPUB fixed layout feature. So I'm going to create this from scratch. So start with File, New Document. My intent is digital publishing. And I'll go for the basic iPad size, 1024x768, but I'll make it portrait so it looks like a portrait poster. I actually don't need a primary text frame for this, and I'll just click on OK. So the first thing I want to do is create a parchment background. What I've done is I've sourced a parchment from the internet, and what I've done is taken out or made the center transparent and saved it as a PNG, and I did that in Photoshop. And I'm just going to stretch that across my entire page, and I've now got to place my frame. I just place my frame so none of the white or transparent layers of the parchment are showing below. And I'll just open up my layers area here. So I've got my frame which is sitting on top and my parchment which is sitting on the back. Now I want to place my video, but I won't actually do a place. I'll actually go to Media. Now if your right hand side doesn't look like this, you can actually open any of the items up here under Window, and when they actually appear, you can drag them across. No overlays I already have, but you can drag them across and dock them into this panel. So with Media, I select Import Media. And what I did was I actually used Premiere Pro to set the size of my media to be the same size as this area here. So I measured it out, realizing that it probably had to be about 650 by 590. So I just click and the video will place in. Now I can align that a little bit better, but with my layers, what I want to make sure is that my video sits below. And if I need to reach the video even though it's sitting underneath, what I can do is hide some of the layers. Looks like I made my video a little tiny or too small, but that's alright. If I move my frame out a little bit and then fit my content to the frame, it'll make it a little bit bigger. And I can move that around. If I want to see what that video looks like in the media, I can actually go to my EPUB interactivity preview, and when it actually press the play button, that will load it up and my video will play. So what further things I wanted to do with my video was I wanted to play on page load and I want it to continuously loop as it did in the Prisoner of Azkaban poster. I don't want a controller, and what I might do is even before putting any headings on here, I can publish this online. So publish as a new document for the poster and publish. When it's uploaded, I can click View Document and it'll view my document online. And I can share that link with other people as well. Alright, that's enough of the scary face. One thing you can do as well is when the document is uploading, you can close and continue working on the document. That's useful if you're making, you know, you're making changes and you just want to have a preview of the document. And with the headings and text and so forth, I'll just show one of the frames. So select a text frame. Now I had some fonts that I downloaded from Typekit and I happen to like Sunflower. Select the text. Make it large. And what I can do is to bring the text in a bit. Just compress that a little bit. If I wanted to put the warning text down here and put that in red, I might again decide to use Sunflower. I might make the font white because I'm going to set the background frame to red. By pressing Control B on the frame, you can actually do things like align the text vertically center. You want to push it in from the left and from the right. A little bit too far. The other thing we can do is when we click on that yellow square that appears, we can turn this into rounded corners if we like. And you can see here that my attempts to bring in that border. Haven't really helped out very much in my district piece of it. Okay, so I put out an extra frame in here as I've done in the one that I've included in the package. But what we'll do now is we'll just save as poster and then export. As a fixed layout epub. And I can check this button down below to say publish online after your epub export. Once you've set your conversion settings, it remembers. So I'll now click on OK. And my document has been exported. It will play back much better on a mobile device like an iPad. And here I'm going to just update my existing document. I'll make it a new one, sorry, and then I'll just publish that. It will publish. So give that a go. It doesn't have to be an escaped prisoner. It could be something nicer, like a game in the park, or growing vegetables, or anything that you want to create a Haryy Potter style poster for.